Why do I even bother with those integrated circuits? Look at the complexity of this. Why not to take a microcontroller unit, plug it in, change the code, and that's it. You have millions of features. Now, you are going to stick to this that is going to do only two things, count up and count down. Why? Should you use a microcontroller unit for every application? Well, the answer is no. But the right implementation can have huge benefits. So in this episode, we want to see and create a few different circuits with and without an MCU to show how valuable it can be. If you have no clue what MCU is, you can check our previous episode where we talk about what they are, what they consist of, and what they can do. The main idea of those circuits is to drive a 7-segment display in various ways and compare the building process complexity. But let's find out what a 7-segment is and what kind of types we have. So, as the name suggests, 7-segment display is a small, not this one, it's pretty large, it's a small modified matrix that consists of 7 LEDs. 7. They can be controlled individually to form a number, a letter, or even a sign like dot or a dash or a slash. There are two kinds of these displays, common cathode and common anode. In the common cathode display, all the cathodes of the LED segments are connected to the ground, while anode terminals are driven individually with a suitable driving circuit that can source current. Common anode displays work vice versa. All the anode connections are connected to a positive voltage supply, while cathode terminals need to be connected to a driver circuit which can sink current. Common terminals configurations can greatly reduce terminal pins and especially reduce headaches when trying to count each pin. Fun fact, this type of display is one of the oldest and the most efficient in displaying numbers in various applications. Since it is affordable and has high visibility, it is one of the most popular displays used in action films as countdown timers for explosions. Now that we understood how this 7-segment works, we can continue to our simple circuit that counts from 0 to 9. For the MCU circuit, we will use those components: an Arduino board, 330 ohm resistors, a prototyping board, a common cathode 7-segment display. The circuit is quite simple. We connect each anode connection to a resistor and from there to a certain MCU pin, while two common cathode pins are tied to the ground. Connection to the digital pins need to be exactly as shown in the schematics, otherwise writing the code will be at least 3 times harder. When everything is soldered in place, it is time for some coding. We will begin by creating a two-dimensional array for the individual segment control. The array row size tells us how many numbers we will display, and columns represent each segment's information. The array is filled with information that is taken from the common cathode display truth table. To put it simply, the truth table tells us which segment to turn on to display a certain number or a character. Later, we will create a new void function called displayNumber, which will be helpful for future code changes. In void setup using for loop, we declared that our Arduino micro digital pins from 2 to 8 will be used as outputs. In the void loop, we create another loop, which will count from 0 to 9 and send that number to our created function. A 2-second delay is also added between the counting numbers. We will finish writing our previously created display number function in the last lines of code. First and foremost, we create an integer called pin and set it to 2. It will be helpful later to faster change the pin that we are controlling. Afterward, for loop is created to help read values from array rows. In that loop, the digital write command sets the voltage of the certain pin, which is determined by the array. In the last line, pin++ changes the pin that we are using and then repeats the cycle until all highs and lows are read from the chosen array row. After uploading the code, there you have it, a fully working counter. Actually saw it in the beginning, but here it is. Without an MCU, it's going to be horrible. It starts with the component list that consists of a common anode 7 segment display, the 74 LS90 decade counter, the 74 LS47 decoder driver, the push button and the resistors. But if you ever decide to build those circuits by yourself, there are links to TME's website where you can find all the components that you need and much more. Next, let's understand what those integrated circuits are responsible for. So I'll just connect it and demonstrate. Oh, zero. Now, can you see it? Can you see it? Can you see it?
Yes.
Okay. Press the button. I skipped the number. It's okay. It's because I'm touching some stuff. But basically, when the push button is pressed, the counter creates a binary number. Each time the button is pressed, the counter counts from 0000 to 1001, from 0 to 9, and then it goes back to 0. It is used because otherwise you will have to manually generate the binary numbers using 4 switches. Now, 74 LS47 display driver receives that signal and converts it to a decimal number. Using its 7 output pins, the driver controls segments so that a newly converted decimal number will appear on the display. Building this circuit takes time, effort, and most importantly, concentration, as one mistake can heavily impact on your design and on the functions. We have successfully created a counter in 2 different ways. Let's step it up a bit. Now we want to create a counter that counts up and down. You might think that we need to make some hardware tweaks and changes in the MCU one, but that's not the case. The only thing that we need to change is the software. Anyways, here, by the press of the button, counts up and it counts down. Ta-da! For the non-MCU circuit, this kind of change is horrible. Sadly, we must throw what we created previously, grab new components, because our this circuit cannot count down.
Why?
It doesn't have the capability. Why we didn't use it at the beginning? I don't know. Anyways. We will use new components. A CD40110, an up-down counter integrated circuit, a common cathode display, various resistors and capacitors, switches, and a 555 timer. The new CD40110 counter adds more capabilities, like a new push button for counting down and also extra push button for count reset. However, this integrated circuit has one drawback. You see, this is the reset. Up, or down. Yeah, so by pushing the up or down button, you won't produce numbers that are always sequential. This occurs because the counter needs to receive a perfect square signal that to its input. Because of this, we need a 555 timer that will generate that perfect clock. It will be connected to A or B connections, depending on the way that you want to count. After everything is soldered in place, you can clearly see how much harder and more complex it is to use integrated circuits for this case. But who wants to see only numbers? Even in math, you get more letters than numbers, so the next adjustment is to present the alphabet from A to F. In the circuit with the MCU, all we need to do is to change the code. We need to adjust the for loop and change the name of the number array to alphabet array, and that's all. It's quick and simple. Look. Come on. Oh, A or A, B, whatever. Yes? The other circuit is a bit different story. It's horrible. Displaying letters without MCU is not that simple and can get extremely complex. Therefore, we will use the previously utilized integrated circuit, the 74LS47, and control it manually using switches. In other words, we will generate a 4-bit binary number with them so that the driver module could display letters on the display. Thank you. finally prove that MCU can do amazing things, we are going to display random stuff, like numbers and characters, basically what we had. To do this, we need to fill the array with all the characters that we used before and to add two additional lines to generate random numbers. And the circuit works like a charm. Without an MCU, making this kind of circuit will be horrible. Last thoughts. As you can tell from the circuits, an MCU can be an indispensable tool for all kinds of applications. You can change the whole working principle of the circuit by modifying a few lines of code. Moreover, advanced MCUs that come with a built-in Wi-Fi capabilities can be updated from the other side of the planet. Doing this not only reduces the time that takes to update, but also resources. Actually, here is a little glimpse from the future technology. Here I am wearing special goggles. I can see the real world and on the shades I can see the machine. By pinching some of the virtual switches, the machine is reacting in real time. You can check the full interview on our channel. So there are optimized programs and machines that are simply the best for doing one thing, and there are the others that can do various things, but they are not the experts. Regardless of your application or your choice, go to tme.eu, we have them all.